लेट अस डिस्कस आर लेट अस कंटिन्यू आर डिस्कशन. ओके, द लास्ट स्लाइड वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज द पैरेलल एडर एंड और व्हाट इज द रिपल कैरी एडर, राइट? सो नाउ व्हाट वाज द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ रिपल कैरी एडर? द कैरी द कंसेक्यूटिव और द नेक्स्ट कैरी इज गोइंग टू डिपेंड ऑन द प्रीवियस कैरी, राइट? अंटिल एंड अनलेस द प्रीवियस कैरी कम्स, वी कैन नॉट परफॉर्म एनी further addition, right? So that was the biggest disadvantage of parallel adder or ripple carry adder. Now we will see how to overcome that problem using carry look ahead adder. Carry look ahead adder, right? So in simple terms, you can say this is the block diagram, or this is the combination circuit in which we are going to see the carry well in advance before we are going to add, right? So the carries are readily available. That means that the next blocks are not going to depend on the previous carries, right? So the carries are readily available with the circuit or with the user, and we can perform the addition or parallel addition, right? So in that case, in this case, the addition operation is going to happen in very fast compared to the parallel addition or ripple carry addition, right? So to discuss this combination circuit, we need to use the concept of a full adder, right? So full adder takes three inputs and gives two outputs, three inputs and two outputs, right? So let me write the truth table of full adder, right? So why full adder is required? Because parallel adder as well as this carry look ahead adder, inside they have full adder circuit. Okay, 011 100 101 110 and 111, right? Now sum is 0, carry is 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1, right? So I don't have any problem with the sum, right? So sums are readily available, right? I have a problem with the carry, right? So what I'll do, I'll put a k-map for carry. Okay, so once I get rid of this problem with the carry, then some problem, even if they arise, then that is also resolved using this technique. Okay, so A, B, C are the three inputs, 1 0 0 1, right? So this is 0th cell, first cell, third cell, second, 4 5 7 6. So put this 3 3 is high, 4 0 5 6 7 5 6 7. Now group them using normal k-map. Okay, so this is BC plus, this is A and C, and these two are grouped. Final expression is AC plus BC plus AB. So this is the Boolean expression for carry. So what I'll do in these two terms, I'll take C common. So what remains inside the bracket is A plus B, and this term will remain as it. So here I'll call this term as G and this term as P, right? So G stands for generator, and P stands for propagator, right? So you can say G generator will generate a carry, and the propagator will propagate that carry from one block diagram, one full adder to another full adder. So how to see this, that we will discuss in more detail. Okay, so just remember this final expression, that is C into P, right? So how can I write the, now if I substitute C's and G's in this final expression, it will become C into P plus G, right? So this will be, this is the expression what we are going to see. Further, we are going to open this expression, right, for different full adders, and we will write those expressions. Okay, just remember the final expression, that is carry is equal to C inside bracket P plus G, where G is a generator and P is a propagator. Now if I let us say I'll redraw that parallel adder circuit. Okay, taking the second method, that is for full adders what we have used, right? So this is a parallel adder, what we discussed in the last slide, A1, B1. So instead of representing the first two inputs as A0, B0, I have taken it as A1 and B1, because you can give any name to those inputs. Okay, so this is first full adder, output is S1, and one more output is C1, carry is C1, and sum is S1. Second inputs, for second full adder, the inputs are A2 and B2, output is C2, and here output is S2. Next, for the third full adder, inputs are A3, B3, outputs are S3 and C3. And the last one, fourth full adder, S4, A4, B4, and the last one is C4. Right? So this is the block diagram of a parallel adder. Right? So now if I write the generalized expression, right? So let us say carry, this is the final carry what I wrote, right? But here I have in intermediate carries as well, right? So C1, C2, C3 and C4. C4 will be the final carry. If I add one more block there, then C4 will also become an intermediate carry. Okay, so now if I write for C1, what I can write, C1 is equal to C, instead of the previous carry, this C is a previous carry. What is the previous carry for first block diagram? It is C0, right? So then I'll write it as P1, because I'm writing for C1, right? So inputs are C0, P1 plus G1 for first block diagram, right? Next, similarly, C2 is equal to, so what is P1 here? Let me write what is P1 and G1. P1 is A1 plus B1 and G1 is A1 into B1. Okay. Next, what is C2? C2 is going to depend on the previous carry. So previous carry will be equal to C1 and inputs are P2 and G2. So what is P2? P2 is A2 plus B2, because A's and B's are readily available along with the initial carry, that is C0. Okay. Then what is G2? It is A2, B2. Similarly, C3 is C2, the previous carry is C2, then P3 and G3. So what is P3? P3 is A3 plus B3 and G3 is A3 into B3. And the last one, C4. What is C4? C3, because C4 is going to depend on C3. C3, P4 plus G4. What is P4? P4 is A4 plus B4 and G4 is A4 into B4, right? So now if I generalize this expression, these four expressions, how can I generalize it? See, Ci is equal to Ci minus 1 Pi plus Gi, right? So this is the generalized expression for these four expressions. Just put i is equal to 1, what you will get? C1 is equal to C0 P1 plus G1. Is it same as this expression? Yes. Right? I'll name it as first expression. Second, if I put I is equal to 2, right? So here what is going to happen? C1 is going to depend on the previous carry, that was the initial carry, you can say, C0. Right? Now, C2. C2 in parallel addition, C2 was depending on C1, but I need to remove this problem. I need to overcome this problem. That means I should make C2 nowhere. It should not be going to depend on this C1. It should not be going to depend on C1. So by this we can overcome the problem of ripple carry. Okay. So C2. If I put I is equal to 2 in this expression, what happens? C2 is equal to C1, 2 minus 1 is 1, then P2 plus G2, right? So now I have an expression for C1, right? So from the first, put 1 in 2, right? So what happens? C2 is equal to, if I substitute C0, P1 will substitute for C1 first, plus G1, okay, and P2 plus G2, right? So if I elaborate, or if I substitute the P's and G's here, what happens? C0, P1 is A1 plus B1, substitute P1, what is P1? A1 plus B1, plus what is G1? A1 dot B1, right? Plus into P2, P2 is A2 plus B2, right? Plus G2 is A2 into B2, right? So in this expression you see, so what I said here, C2 is going to depend on the previous carry, that is C1. Until and unless this C1 comes, I cannot generate sum 2 and C2, right? But here you see, C2 is no way going to depend on C1. Do you have C1 in this expression? No, right? So C2 is also going to depend on C0 and A's and B's. But these A's, B's and C0 are readily available for the user, and we can make use of those inputs, and we can generate the outputs, right? So C2, we got rid of C2, we got rid of C1 in the expression of C2. Similarly C3, if I put I is equal to 3 in the generalized expression, what we will get? C3 is equal to C2 P3 plus G3, right? So if I substitute C2 again in this place, again C3 is going to depend on only C0 and A's and B's, right? So here I made C3 independent on this C2. That means C3, all these expressions, all these carries, intermediate carries, or the final carry you can take, they are going to depend on only A's, B's and this C, which are readily available for the user, and with the help of those inputs we can generate the sums and the carries very fast. So here none of the intermediate carry is going to depend on the previous carry generated, right? So that was the concept of carry look ahead adder. Okay, so in next slide we will discuss the final block diagram of this carry look ahead adder. I hope you understood the concept of carry look ahead adder. Okay, so now we will see, we are ready to draw the block diagram of carry look ahead adder. We are going to draw a carry look ahead adder. From the final those expressions what I discussed, that is C1 is equal to, right? What was C1? C1 was after substituting I is equal to 1 in the final expression. Let me refer those expressions. C1 is C0 P1 plus G1. C0 P1 plus G1. Right? So substitute this C0 A1 plus B1 plus A1 B1. This is the first expression. Expression A. Next, C2. What is C2? It is C1 P2 plus G2. Substitute C1, right? So I can write it as C0 P1 plus G1. In terms of P's and G's, I can write C1 as C0 P1 plus G1 into P2 plus G2. So this is expression B, right? So using these expressions, we are going to draw the block diagram of carry look ahead at C. Now, how to draw that? So this is 1-bit adder. What are the inputs? Inputs are going to remain same. Those are A1, B1, okay. So C0, that is the initial carry which is kept as 0, right? And from this we are going to obtain what? S1, that is sum 1, right? So and along with this A1, B1 and C0, what we can obtain along with A1, B1 and C0. A1, B1 and C0 we can obtain P1 and G1, right? So what is P1? A1 plus B1. A1 plus B1, that is P1. So instead of getting directly the final carry, so we are going to generate all the carries at a time, that is C1, C2, C3 and C4. All those carries will be generated at the same time. So I can get with A1 and B1, I can get P1, right? So with A1 and B1 I can get P1, and A1 and B1 I can get G1, right? So these are P1 and G1, right? So this will be given along with C0. This will be given to one more block here, which we call it as 4-bit carry look ahead. What we call it as carry look ahead generator, right? So this block is going to generate all those carries at the same time, and whenever the carries are required by these block diagrams, one bit adder block diagrams, those will be supplied by this block diagram. Okay, so that is second inputs are A2 and B2. Now this will not supply the carry for this, but this block diagram will supply the carry for next, because C1 is going to depend on A1 and B1, which is equal to P1, right? So P1 is given to this block diagram, and G1 is going to this block diagram. Along with this, we are going to supply C0 as well, right? So all these three, P1, G1 and C0, will constitute a C1, and that C1 will be given to the next block, that is 1-bit adder, right? So you can ask the question, right? So even C1 is getting propagated now from this block diagram, but it is not going to depend on initial carry, right? C1 is going to depend on initial carry, but these A's, B's and initial carry, they are readily available because C0 is grounded. Initially C0 is equal to kept 0, right? So these are readily available inputs, right? So with the help of these readily available, this doesn't take much time to generate C1, right? So again, it has a drawback. What is the drawback of that? If this block develops more time to generate a C1, again that will be a problem, right? So but we are concentrating on we are making the consecutive carries, the successive carries, independent on what the previous carries, right? So that was the concept here, right? We are making the next carries independent of the previous carries, right? So what are with the A2, B2, with A2, B2 and C1, what we can generate? We can generate P2 and G2, right? So these are P2 and G2, and for next block diagram, C2 is supplied from this. Okay, so this is C2. What are the inputs here? A3, B3, and again this is 1-bit adder. And the outputs are S3 and P3, G3, and the final one inputs are A4, B4, this is C3, and this is 1-bit adder. Outputs are S4 and this is P4, G4, and the final carry is from this block diagram, that is C, right? So this is the block diagram of carry look ahead adder. So I hope you understood the concept of a parallel adder, and what was the drawback of parallel adder, and how that drawback was overcome in case of carry look ahead adder. Okay, thank you.